Hello everyone. Just a day after I posted lesson one of the Master Zotero series that I am doing, a new version of Zotero, Zotero 7, was launched. This is the biggest upgrade in Zotero in 18 years, and this is a truly welcome change. In light of the release of Zotero 7, it became imperative for me to create a quick bridge lecture for lesson one to show how the user interface has changed in Zotero 7 such that you can find your way around easily. This bridge lecture for lesson one, therefore, just focuses on changes and does not attempt to recreate the entire content of lesson one posted earlier, which remains absolutely valid. I will be using Zotero 7 for all subsequent lessons in this series. Let me show you one by one what has changed. And let's start from installation. Now, as far as installation of Zotero and the Zotero connector in the browser is concerned, there's absolutely no change. Let's revisit the download page quickly. So when you come to the Zotero site and click on the download link, you will see the new version of Zotero, that is Zotero 7, available for download. Clicking here will reveal availability of Zotero 7 for macOS and Linux. So apart from the change of logo and just some little touch up on the page, there's nothing that has changed. Just download and install Zotero 7 for your OS as you would do for installing any other software on your computer. The same is also true for the Zotero connector. Reach this site using the browser of your choice or multiple browsers, and then go ahead and install the connector for your browser as we have seen in lesson one. So apart from the fact that we have a new version of Zotero, that is Zotero 7, and a fresh new logo for Zotero, the look and feel and the functionality of this page essentially remains the same as shown in lesson one for Zotero 6. Next is the browser connector. So in lesson one, we had seen that the browser connector is used for capturing pages on the internet or resources on the internet and then bring them inside Zotero. So the browser connector interface is just the same. Let's have a look. So when you come on a page, you can capture it exactly in the way that we have seen before. Just come to the Zotero icon and click on it, and you will see that the page is now being transferred into Zotero. Go to another page and you will see that the icon has changed just like we have seen before. Click on it and this is also being sent to Zotero. So the connector inside the browser works in exactly the same way as before. There's absolutely no change. Now, as far as user interface is concerned, it's here that the changes have taken place. Some of these changes are in the design of the user interface and some additional functionality has been added. However, all this has been done very intelligently, and there's absolutely no reason why anybody should feel out of place. Everything looks familiar, and people who have been using Zotero for a long time should not feel lost at all. They should find their way quite easily. Let me show you what the new user interface looks like and take you through some of the important changes. So when you first start Zotero 7, one of the first things that catches your eye are the new and contemporary icons that you can see all around the user interface. As far as outlay of the screen goes, nothing has fundamentally changed here. You will see that this left pane is for my library and all the items inside my library. The little tag box is right where it used to be. The central part of the user interface window is showing you all the items that you have collected. So this remains essentially the same. And on the right side, you have your info pane, and it's here inside the info pane that you can see the maximum number of changes. You will recall from version 6 that the info, notes, tags, and related tabs used to be situated horizontally on top of this window. All those icons have now gone here and they are now vertically situated. I'll come to this and explain all these icons and the changes that have happened here in a minute. The buttons at the top are exactly the same, but the icons have changed. And you will remember this magic wand from lesson one. When you click on this wand, you can actually capture items from the internet using identifiers like ISBN and DOIs. We have already covered this in lesson one for Zotero 6, and this remains exactly the same. One important change that will gladden the hearts of many people is that Zotero 7 now supports a dark theme. So to activate the dark theme, you can come to Edit and click on Settings. And the moment you see the settings screen, you will see some changes here as well. In the previous versions of Zotero, all these tabs used to be horizontally stacked up here. Now they are vertically stacked one on top of each other for better accessibility. And this gives the user interface a very modern and fresh look. You will notice right at the top of the general tab that Zotero now supports a dark theme. So for all the people who love the dark theme, you can just come here to the general tab and choose this option. Zotero will now start working with a dark theme. You can go back to the light theme like this. The default is automatic. Just remember that from the general tab, we have an option of choosing the dark theme. I'm going to close this. Now let's come back to the info pane and see that the maximum number of changes have taken place. All these tabs that were horizontally stacked are now vertically stacked for better presentation and access. So this right pane has now been divided into sections. So the info or the metadata about this resource is residing in the first section, that is the info section, which you can collapse using this button here. So just click on it and the info section will collapse. And the same is available for other sections as well. So collapse or expand using this particular button. You can click on these fields like you were able to do before in version 6 and earlier to change the item type. You can right click on the title and change between title case and sentence case as we could do before. Two new options have been added. One is copy and one is paste. If you ever wanted to copy this title or paste another version of the title, the URL and the DOI buttons are no longer clickable. But as you move horizontally across, you'll find that there's a button in the end. When you click on this button, you are taken to the page inside your browser. Next to info is the abstract button. So when you click on it, you are directly taken to the abstract section. Clicking the info button takes you back again to the top of the info section. So this is the abstract button. Now the next button after abstract is the attachment button. Remember that Zotero takes a snapshot and this is stored locally on your computer, as I mentioned in lesson one. So this is actually an attachment to this particular resource. So when you click on this button, you will now see the next section, which is the attachment section here. And if we can just collapse these two so you can see this much better. So we have the info section, then we have the abstract section. And now this button takes us to the attachment section. And you can see a preview of that web page right here. You don't have to see it inside the browser. A browser has been included right here. And if you come to this right pane and stretch it, you can actually read the entire page right here. So this is like a really major, major convenience. If you, however, wanted to read this in a full page view, just double click on this and a tab opens up inside Zotero and you can read the page in its expanded view. You don't have to use a browser. This is now possible from inside Zotero itself. And you'll also notice that just like for PDFs, Zotero 7 now provides some annotation tools for snapshots as well. So you can highlight items or you can underline any paragraph and you can also create notes. So all this is possible for snapshots just like you can do for PDFs. So this is the new feature that has been introduced in Zotero 7, the feature to annotate snapshots. Likewise for PDFs also. So when you click on this parent item, you will see details in the info section, and then you can go to the abstract section, and then you can go to the attachment section where you will see this PDF and you can just simply look at all the pages. As you expand this pane, you may be able to read some part of it, and to read it in a full page view, just double click on it and it'll open in a full page view right inside Zotero. The next button is the notes button. So when you click on it, you are taken here. Or you can scroll down and come here yourself. And then you can click on it and add your notes. We have already seen how this works, so I'm not going to explain this. This is for tags. So when you click on it, you are taken here. You can also scroll down and come here. Don't need to press these buttons. But if you do, you are transported directly to the tags section and you can add your tags as we have seen in lesson one. And the last one is for related items. So when you click on it, you come to the related items section and you can click on this button and add any resource in your library that is related to this particular item. So as you click on the main parent item, you have all these sections visible. So it is in the right pane that the maximum number of changes have taken place in the user interface. And I request you to take some time out and just explore this yourself. You will find that this is like really very nicely laid out. We'll talk about this last button later. When you click on it, you can actually search for this item on Google Scholar and so on and so forth. I'll talk about this later in another lesson. So in lesson one, in Zotero 6, I had told you about how to annotate PDFs using the tools that Zotero provides. In Zotero 7, there has been some change in PDF annotation. Some new tools have been provided, and the annotation has in fact become much better. So let's have a quick look at PDF annotation in Zotero 7. So here you'll see that we have a PDF available. So I'm going to double click on it and open it inside a tab. And you will see that the icons have changed here. This one is for highlight, so you can just simply go ahead and highlight it. And the moment you highlight it, it appears here. This one is for underline. So a new button has been provided. So this is for underlining. And if you come here and click on these dots, some new options are available. You can convert the underlines to highlights and highlights to underlines as required. So this is the new option that is available, and the underline is available from this particular button. We have already seen notes, just that in Zotero 7 PDF annotation, the icon has changed. So another new button has been provided here, and that is to add text. So you can come here and choose a color and then type in some text. So this is the new button. We have already seen the select area button, using which we can capture a portion of this PDF and save it as an image. And another new tool has been provided here, that is the draw tool. So using which you can actually freely draw. This is like the ink tool. And you can just simply come here and mark something in freehand. And while you are using this draw tool, if you expand this little drop down here, you can also have access to an eraser, and you can also change the width of the line that you are drawing. So clicking on the eraser, you can come here and rub out anything that you want. And then you can come back and pick up your drawing tool and draw that particular item once again. So these are some of the new tools that have been provided. And right at the bottom here, you will see that you can sort these comments based on the ink that has been used. So if you click on this blue button here, you will see only that note which has something drawn in blue ink. Just click on it once again to get all your notes back. If you click on the green button, you will see only those items which are having green. And this is the piece of text that I had written in green. Click on it once again and you get all your items back. And if you click on yellow, you will see that it will show you all the items that have been marked in yellow ink. This is the one that I highlighted, and this is the one that I had underlined. And if you want to read the PDF in a larger area, just click on this particular button here. So you can then expand or collapse the context pane and read this in an enlarged view. So these are some of the changes that have taken place in the PDF section. Some new annotation tools and some new buttons. So this brings us to the end of this bridge class. I hope this video has been useful in helping you transition to Zotero 7. The new Zotero 7 is in fact quite similar to the earlier versions, yet through this upgrade, it brings about a very contemporary design change and many new useful features for its users. I congratulate the Zotero development team for such an intelligent, thoughtful, and useful upgrade to this beloved software. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments section. I look forward to seeing you in Lesson 2 and other subsequent lessons, which I will demonstrate in Zotero 7. Many thanks for watching.